Okay, recording is started, bruv. Yo, 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 what is up, YouTubers? It is your boy, MenXYZ, bringing you another random Rekking video. Like, I literally just recorded the first one, and then I'm like, okay, I'm gonna do a second one, because, like, it's actually kind of addicting. And the store's like, wow. But yeah, like, I'm just gonna go ahead and choose a new random loadout, and we'll see what we get, because I'm personally just curious just to see what the hat wants to select for me today. So with that being said, I'm just gonna go ahead. I should have made a template for this, but I can just type it up again real quick. Actually, nah. I can just copy and then delete. That should be quicker than retyping. Yeah, yeah. So it's always gonna be heads or tails between the Rigadoon and the BTB, and the other three weapons are gonna be random, and then the armor and the helmet is gonna be random. So right now we have the hat and it's set to armor list, so we'll go ahead and choose something. I'll add the music. So I gotta use a Mercurial demo suit. That's pretty decent, because I get some shock res, elemental res, you know, good against Polaris and Storm Driver. I don't mind using that. I don't get any damage bonuses whatsoever, though, besides all my bombs, so hey, if they select me bombs, if they give me a bomber set, you never know. Okay, and now we're gonna go ahead and open up the helmet. I just wanna see what helm. So, draw. Oh. Oh shit. Bro, guess what I got?
What?
The jelly helm, bro.
Rip.
Jelly helm Mercurial demo, bro. No damage bonuses, like rip. Oh, this is gonna be painful. Okay. This is time for me to show my skill. Alright. Saved lists, weapons. So first off, heads or tails for the BTB or Rigadoon. So, tails BTB, heads Rigadoon. Wait, no, I want to do coin flip. So, heads Rigadoon again, Rigadoon. Weapon 2 now. Let's see. Weapon 2. Guess what I got, bro? It's one of the items that you're using soon. Jet Venom Striker.
Oh, jeez.
Next up, we got Storm Driver. Ah, try hard. Let's go.
Oh, no.
Dude, Storm Driver and Jet Venom. Dude. These guys are giving me some decent loadouts, like, pretty much no damage bonus. They're pretty much telling me that I gotta go try hard with no damage, like, oh my god. And the last weapon is gonna be Voltaic Tempest. Interesting. Yeah, eh? That'll be interesting. Damn. Damn, bro. Damn, bro, like, dude, like, just take it in, like, I'm just gonna message it to you, and you're gonna be like, this is my set, like. And then two pentas.
Oh.
Yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and make that loadout. So, Jelly Helm, I think I have UVs on this shit. OP, look at the UVs, bro. Piercing Mad, Freeze Low, 2 OP.
Wait, yeah, is it seriously just a 2-star helm?
Yeah, just a 2-star. Like, it's legit jelly helm.
Why do you have that?
I don't even know, bro. I think I just found it, like, really cheap on the auction house, and it had piercing man, and I'm like, hey, I'll make an ice queen helm out of it, and I just never got around to it, you know? Because it was piercing man freeze low, so as an ice queen, is actually not bad, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah. That was gonna be for costume purposes mostly, but it's fine. It's perfectly fine, bro. Weapon 1, Fearless Rigadoon. Weapon 2, Dread Venom Striker. CTR Med. Weapon 3, Storm Driver. Weapon 4, Voltaic Tempest. Do I want it in this order? Not really. I'm going to keep it in this order. Alright. This is my random Rekking episode 2 loadout. And now we shall begin. Bang. I have like defenses against everything right now. Barely.
Wow.
Like, it's, like you'll see. Check out the gear stats. I have like a little tiny bit of everything. Cause I have like Shadow High on the Merc demo soon.
Damn.
Just a little bit of everything. That's not really going to do any difference. If anything, I'm at a disadvantage, but still something. So, without further ado, let's go on ahead and sign up for RLD.
That's sleep low, though.
That's sleep low. It's on the jelly hum, though.
Yeah.
It's OP. OP. Yeah, it's book. Imagine it's like a sleep gun.
Damn. Oh, God.
That'll be crazy. Like, the only way that would ever let that happen is like if you can only inflict the sleep status via charge, and you have to stay still during that charge. Like, they would have to nerf that. They would have to nerf that, bro. But I mean, pretty much sleep is like, actually, freeze is worse than sleep in a way. Like, at least with sleep you recover a bit of health. With freeze you can attack, but you can't really recover your health. So I don't know. Like, they're kind of similar. You're pretty much stuck still. But yeah. This is the loadout. Fearless Rigadoon, ASI low, Jet Venom Striker, CTR med, level 5. Voltaic Tempest, level 8, CTR med. And then Storm Driver, level 10, ASI med. Interesting. So you're gonna be like, what the hell are you wearing, Mini? I'll be like, honestly, I don't even know, bro. But like, I just got selected to wear it, so I'm gonna wear it. Yeah, man. Okay. So I can go on ahead, save this. Save it to my desktop. Yeah. Alright. Wait, what? It's a folder? Oh, what? Okay, I guess I'll save it as that then. Oh, I hate how when you crack games, they freaking detect like one of the files as a virus. Like, bruv, fuck off. I installed Crysis 3. Same thing on the previous computer, yo. The previous gaming that I had, when I installed Crysis 3, they detected one of the files as a virus. I'm like, yeah, sure it is. I just had to like turn off the real time, and then I could install the game and I ran it just fine, no issues later on. Like, I'm just gonna go ahead and spectate, I guess. See what's popping in the meantime. Like, damn, bro. Let's see.
Not Your Cherry is playing.
I'm gonna go spectate that game.
My favorite Guardian.
Are you signed?
No.
Do you wanna sign?
Maybe for like one match, I guess.
Alright. Depending on how soon you get in, I guess. Alright. Go on ahead and play some random Rekking or randomly Rekking lockdown. Not Your Cherry is going the Blaster Guardian. Oh, I experimented with that in lockdown. I was crushing a beef. Like, it's pretty OP. Like, blasters do solid damage, and they knock back too, and they can cancel, so.
Yeah.
They're quite sturdy as weapons, they're just versatile. So, Riftlocker, Phantomus, Wildfire, Polo, it's pretty much one of those Cancer Guardian sets.
Yeah. But I think she's a pretty good Guardian.
True.
Regardless.
That's good. Who's in this group? Sarazita. Interesting. Hopefully I don't get 18 down. Arceus Primigenium. Is that like some species name? Let me look it up. I'm actually curious.
No copyright sound.
Nope, it's nothing. Sounded like a species name. I was just curious, like some people like name them after species. Like, remember someone was like something Paramecium, I'm like, say word. Like my set?
Oh god. Well, at least the pink matches.
Guys, like, well, at least you have some sort of fashion sense, like, done.
Hey.
Like, if I die in this game, like, I'm not even gonna hold a grudge against anyone, because, like, this is not really that kind of a set where I could do a lot with, though. But I'm gonna see what I can do, like, this is the fun about it. Like, you gotta put yourself in these situations, bruv. At least I can single switch Storm.
And yeah.
I just had to go Striker this time. But I'll see, like, Recon could also be beneficial, but Fearless Regidoon doesn't really hit that hard enough to take advantage of the Recon, in my opinion. It's like, once they find me, it's pretty much over.
Well, I mean, like,
okay. When you hit someone who's like out of your camera range, oh, that lag spike.
Rip.
Yeah, I'm getting a few of them still. It's just weird. Hopefully it'll go away after a bit though. I did restart my client though, but I was just getting like random skips. Subtle but crucial.
I'm such a bad recon.
I got a DBS kill.
Nice.
Ew, you're stealing my kills like that, boy.
Well, I'm a recon, that's what recons do.
Oh man.
I'm clearly not a recon main. So I don't even know why I'm going with this.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Interesting. Yo, I'm actually wrecking these people. This day, like, when you see it on my screen, you'll be like, dude, Mini, you're going off. Like, the thing is, I don't have enough damage boosts. You know what I mean?
Damage boosts.
Exactly, I have no damage boosts. Like, oh my god, I'm gonna go land a Voltaic Tempest on something real quick.
Wait, does your Voltaic Tempest have CTR?
It has CTR med. UV, and it's like level 8, so I have CTR low on top of that, so like I'm still negative low CTR overall. Okay, now it's time for me to plant it. when it somehow manages to hit you. When it somehow manages to hit you when you're clearly not exactly in its range. But, hey, it is a charge after all, so I guess you just gotta assume that his range is a little bit bigger than a second swing Grand Frost. It's safe to assume that. But yeah, like, I can't really be hitting much damage with this. I don't even have any gun damage bonus. Like, this is horrendous. I have no damage bonuses, bro. Like, it hurts, because I'll be killing everyone. The amount of hits I'm landing on, though, is ridiculous. But, hey, this proves to show you guys that, you know, gear definitely does affect things. If I'm running damage max, it'll change the outcome a whole lot. But, I'm glad, like, 8.4k, like, I earned that. Especially using a Fearless Rigadoon, like, you know. Fearless Rigadoon, Dribbenum Striker, Storm Driver. I managed to get some shocks though, and that was pretty good. I managed to get like, I think like 2 or 3 shocks. That's nice. Nice to see. I was mostly maining Fearless Rigadoon. I was only planting down the Voltaic Tempest like where it would actually be beneficial. It's like, you know, when you're a striker, you don't have much health to be tanking hits while you're charging. If you're a guardian, you can afford to at least a bit, but a striker not really. So it's really key to like plant your bombs, like be smart about planting your bombs. Plant them in places where people will be going to, but when not many people are around. When you're a guardian, it's good to like just pretty much hold your ground with your shield up, and then when people start coming, you plant your bomb to establish your territory. It's a little bit different, but like with strikers, you establish your territory in advance so you can go back into your blast radius, recover your strike booster, and then you can go back out and you can attack with your sword real quick. But even then, the bomb cloud doesn't last for like that long, but still long enough for you to recover your boost.
Yep.
Alright. Let's see who we got over there. They got Solars Nicole. Wait, no, that's us. They got Shadow Cookies, Sarazita, Louisva, Twixter, Arceus, Primigenium, and Lefender. And you decided to play again, eh?
Hey.
The Sorcerer.
What class?
Like, you gotta change your name to Sorop, bro. Like,
no. Sorop. It doesn't flow. What class?
You know what does
guardian?
Flow? My mixtape. And
oh my god.
Sure. I haven't seen you play as a guardian. So, hey. Alright. Mercurial Jelly. No damage bonus. We got some shock resistance on this. A tiny little bit of stun resistance. Shao didn't even bother. He's like, bruv, where did that come from? I thought I hit them with my Storm Driver there. Okay then. Alright. Okay then. Dude, I'm the person who does sneak attacks. You can't be sneak attacking on these Shadow fucking cookies. Like, don't forget I crush you with my alt, bro. Wow, that lag spike was so crucial. Like, dude, I was gonna go for the kill there and then like I just teleport. Like, damn, son. Holy cow.
Wow, I have my shield down and everything.
Mm-hmm. And you're still crushing beef.
These people don't even go for the kill.
Dead. Oh my god. Dude, was that you? Oh no, who's the recon? Solars Nicole just destroyed him. Destroyed Shadow Cookies with a freaking Voltage Charge, bro. Like, deleted. Rip. Aw, never came. Okay. This guy should be guarding. If he has a Guardian Shield and there's already a Striker on the point, he should be just holding a shield up, to be honest. This lag is unbearable. Damn, Sora. Why are you such a bully, boy? Now's my time to bully someone. No! Oh, that dash! It's my fault. I'm using mouse. I gotta stop using mouse movement and use WASD, bro. But it's like, mouse is always just so comfy to use. It's just so much comfier. And nonchalant is just so chill. But like, if I want a tactical advantage, I gotta use WASD and like this, and like be able to spin. I can't do it like this. I gotta actually use my left hand. Ah, I'm using WASD. Mouse movement again. I should probably turn it off. Why are you giving him a Vinci sword?
I did.
Who was that? Was that Blaze? I swear I saw a Guardian kill. There was a Guardian just now. Because I was hitting
him. I didn't hit him before you died.
Bruh. I literally just got three hit. Like, I just got Grand Frosted, though.
Well, I can tell you it wasn't me.
I guess there's probably another Guardian.
I was trying to save you, but no.
I don't know.
With a lunge.
Whoa!
Wait, what happened?
This guy managed to escape. I was chasing him down with my straight booster. I'm dying. This set is way too weak offensively to compete with Skulver, like, fuck. A no damage Rigadoon versus a Skulver is like cancer, bro. Like, do you know how many hits I have to land? I don't land so many hits. And then when it's in a group, it's even worse. Like, goddamn. Oh, okay. Rip. Rip. See how many hits this guy even takes? Even these guys take hits for days.
Yeah.
This Cobalt guy.
I can't play Guardian at all. Like, I need a good team to back me up as a Guardian as well. Because I can't solo Guardian. I mean, yeah, we have like 5 Guardians on our team, but...
Shadow Cookies and his Grand Frost.
Shadow Cookies and his Acheron.
Both of them. Ouch, bro. Everyone on our team's getting deathmarked by that recon, though. And the weird thing is, the recon isn't even the one doing all the kills. He's just there deathmarking everyone. He's just like this walking around with the recon mark. And then his team just does the cleanup. It's funny. It's like a good tactics. I want to get some more like one-on-one moments, though. Because like, I can't really handle groups in this kind of a set, bro. Don't have enough guns to even kite. Like, this guy I can handle by myself. Oh, that's definitely for sure. But look at this, bro. Bro. All I see, GF. Oh my god, this hurts. Look at this. Grand Frost spam for fucking days. Like, where? Like, ugh. I just want to shake my head at Ties, bro. I just want to shake my head.
Holy shit, 3 defense.
Damn. I'm just gonna focus on capping, bro. Next game I'll focus on capping, like... Random Rekking, though. I did manage to crush a few people with this set, though. At least, but yeah, all I'm running is like... ew. Right now I'm hitting the same amount of damage as a level 10 Fearless... I mean, Final Flourish, but no damage bonus. At all, like, including no striker damage bonus. Like, that's what I'm hitting with my Fearless Rigadoon damage med, like... Sort of donks. It took me 3 kills to kill a guy in Cobalt, fam. Not Mighty Cobalt, not Azure Cobalt. I mean, like, solid Cobalt or regular Cobalt. It's one or the other, bro. Like, yeah, that was crazy. It's okay. I'm having fun for the most part. Like, it's just, this is like one of the biggest handicaps I've ever played with, though.
And having fun is what matters.
Yeah, this is a hella handicap. If I can break the 10k mark with this set, I'll feel accomplished. And I'm sure I can, with ease. It's just that this was one of those groups where it wouldn't be that simple to get off on. Really wouldn't be. Let's see what we got up next. We got downtown. Ew, another snow map.
Downtown is like one of my best maps.
For me, it's ruins and facility. I like the big maps. Necropolis is alright. It's just alright. I think you're on their team, aren't you?
I didn't sign.
Oh. So like, I don't see you on my team. You're gonna spectate. Or you're just gonna go. And then Twixter. Alright, bruv. That Nosh.
Well, I'll still Twixter, be here, so.
The Fender, Cursed Spirit XX and True. Bella Pip, I think I heard of you, and then Slar Nicole. Interesting. Jelly OP. Bruh. This lag spike is ridiculous, though. Do I gotta turn down my graphics? Hold on, I wanna go ahead and do that. Cause I don't understand why I'm lagging with a 780 Ti. Or it's not even lagging, it's skipping. Like, this is pathetic. And it's actually kind of annoying too. Again. Okay, I guess I just got hit by something. But yeah, my game is skipping. It's pretty annoying. Yep, and again it did. Oh no. I'm probably gonna end up buying more RAM for my PC. All I see was this GF, people dying, like, let the bodies hit the floor. Like, damn. Okay. Well, let's hear Cap like a wannabe bomber. Come here, bitch. Stop running. These guys gotta take me seriously, that's the hilarious part, cause they know. These guys had to double team me, bro.
Oh god.
These guys had to double team, bro. Like, one person with the flares, the next guy came up with a DA, bro. Like, oh, bro, that was harsh. It was 3-on-1. One guy was running, I was bullying him away to the base, like, oh, it was fun. It was fun, bro. And you know what I like about this set, though, to be honest, is that the fact that they can last so many hits is, like, it makes you feel better about yourself, you know what I mean? Because, like, you'd land, like, 5 hits and they're still standing, and it's like, hey, if I was using damage max, I know you would have died already. So, like, you know, like, you can pretty much just tell how many kills you'd be racking up if you're using an actual set. You know, it makes you feel better. And if you can actually manage to kill them in, like, the 7 hits, then it's like, you know, you pretty much dominated them. You know what I mean? Yeah, I'm just gonna go on the dominating flex right now. Lag spikes be like. Rip. That recon be like. What? I don't even know what Solaris is trying to say. I'll show him what a real snipe is. With my Rigadoon boy. I showed him, bro. I dominated him. Like, I showed him, bro. I hit him like 6 times, dude. I hit him like 3 or 4 times with Rigadoon, once again with the Storm Driver, and then again with the Rigadoon to finish him off. And then another guy came, I hit him with Rigadoon, I hit him with Storm Driver, and then I hit him again with Rigadoon. And then when I went for the second swing, he managed to kill me because I missed the second swing of the Rigadoon hit. By a bit, but like it was pretty much one of those times when I had to do it because like I was at 1 bar of health, and it's like either you do it and you hit, or you do it and you miss and die, because either way I was going to die. It was like one of those, oh, that nice ricochet, though. But you don't forget, I have Mind's Eye, so I know where you are, even if you're a recon. So you kind of got to take me a bit more seriously than that. Ew, cursed. Bro.
Combos for days.
Oh my god, bro. This guy came out of nowhere. More like he was up there fighting a different fight, and then I went into his range. Cause it's fine, like it was pretty much like me versing Solar Nicole and then like someone else who's fighting another teammate up in the actual cap circle. I'm going after Solar and then I like do a circle and then bang, I go into someone else's attack and I'm like, oh, rip. You know those ones?
Yeah.
It's just like, oops, I should have been mindful of where I was going. But hey. At the end of the day, I'm having fun using no damage bonuses. Like, it pretty much means that you gotta like hit, play constant pressure. And when you play with these kind of sets, it makes you better as a player, because once you like pop on full cat again, you'd be like, dude, like, I'm so used to like having to use 6 hits to kill you, now I'm killing you in 3-4 hits, like what? Like you just turn into a monster. Like I pretty much used to play with like either like whatchamacallit, a Cyclops cat fencing jacket, and then just use like regular 5-star weapons and my Grand Foss, BTB, etc. And like I still had like the same amount of hits required to kill them, but like I died a lot quicker, so it made me want to play more smart about myself, more conservative. So that's how you play if you want to learn how to be offensive but defensive. And then if you want to use these kind of sets, if you want to learn how to play as a more offensive player, and then if you want to like learn how to pretty much kill people really quickly, then you'd use this kind of a set because it would take you a longer time to kill them. And then once you pop on a damage like bonus set, then you'd be like, oh crap, you die so quickly, I'm not used to using this damage bonus. So it's like, you know, you can pretty much do a mix of them by either playing with 2 pentas and then weak weapons with good gear, and then you can also play with like good weapons and weak gear. So like one of them will make you play more conservative since you die easily, and the other one will make you play more offensive since you gotta land more hits to kill them. And once you play a lot as both of those kind of sets, then it'll make you better as a player, because then you'll be able to play, like then you'll be able to pretty much, I don't know, you'll be pretty much more rounded out as a player is what I want to say, because you'd be used to both styles, playing defensive and playing offensive. So doing this series is going to help me out as a player as well.
I kind of like combine the two when I don't have trinkets because, you know.
Yeah, I feel that.
I put on the aggression as a defense.
I use my Rickadoo. Okay. I'm sorry, bro. I'm really sorry about what I'm gonna do to you. I'm really sorry, bro. Like, that was so cheap. Wait, that was way too cheap, bro. I hit him with the Dread Venom Striker really quick, and I switched to Rickadoo, and I hit him, and it didn't even do anything, bro, and then he hit me. Like, bro. You know what happened this time? I ran out of strike boosters, like I comboed my Rigadoon, but I hit the combo, like it went right into him. I'm like, damn. But like, he hit me too, so like we pretty much both did damage, then I died and he lived. So it was one of those ones, like an exchange of hits. But hey, at least I landed the third hit. What the hell has happened here?
Well, we gotta get ready for tomorrow, so...
Alright, broski. I love this no damage bonus. Oh, okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and heal off this shock and then go up top, because I'm not gonna wait for it to go away. But yeah, bro, you take it easy, have a good night, man. I'm just gonna go ahead and put down a VT. I can handle people on my own. As long as it's one person, maybe two people, but one person easily. It doesn't really matter who the one person is, to be honest, as long as it's one person. That's the one thing I like about this. Oh wow, that double. Why am I wrecking people though? I'm wrecking people, bro. Oh my gosh, like, that's hilarious. Okay. Single switch doesn't want to work. I think I may have fucked up on that one. Oh my gosh, what the hell happened there? I had no invincible frames whatsoever, but... What? Where did my iframes go? Was that 2-on-1 and then all of a sudden I get caught? That was super weird. That was way too weird, bro. Like, what just happened? Okay. Again with the frickin' lag, bro. Stop lagging me! Fucking dang. Lagging me so much. Dude. What's going on? These guys are making me skip all over the point. It's actually cheesing me. Like, dude, if you're gonna give me 4 bars, don't make it jittery, bro. Like, bro. Don't make it jittery. Wow. You couldn't even let me take him on my own, bro. It's okay. It's alright, bro. Like, it's random wrecking. At the end of the day, I've already wrecked them 2-on-1, so... I just took that in. I just forgot. I already did that. That's old news, bro. Who else do I need to wreck? I need to find Cub Smacker. Like, get out of here. Like, you're old news, Shadow, bro. Like... Oh my god, bro, you're old news, like, old news, bro. Like, let me get the new news. Let me get the new news, bro. Old news. Old news. Let me get the new shit, bro. Like, come on, let's go. This is funny. All I hear is shock, shock, shock. I'll shock you guys back then if that's what you want to play. You guys want to play like that? Let's go. Alright, so now. I was just AFK, I'm so sorry about that, guys. Like, someone was talking to me just now, and I was like, oh, I turned on the air conditioning, closed the window. I'm like, okay, I'm recording a video. Like, you know those ones? I'm here, like, trying to, like, balance talking, like, walking around, so I wasn't able to, like, you know, actually attack or anything like that. I only had one hand on the mouse, nothing on my actual. But anyways, that was just interesting, like, that was just really interesting. Alright, I'm back, goddamn. So I'm gonna go ahead, see what's popping, and click play it again. Like, I'm sorry, bro, but, like, those matches were utterly cancer, bro. Like, I'm here playing with it straight up, guys. Like, I'll tell you what it is. I'm here playing with a Jelly Helm Mercurial demo suit, no damage bonuses, and I'm using a Fearless Rigadoon against people using full Sculver, Grandfoss spamming with no toothpicks, Atron Grandfoss. Like, it's really, I don't know what to say, man. Like, I just wish I didn't portray a bit more skill and either A, use a bit more toothpick, or B, simply put on some, like, either B, just put on something that handicaps you as well, you know, rather than just going full on offense. Like, I guess these guys are just playing it to see what kind of damage they can do, and I understand that, because, like, there are times when I'll pull out full cat and just straight up go offensive and, like, you know, see how much damage I can do. But, like, if I'm doing that, I'm not going to be spamming, like, Atron, bro. Like, I'm actually using voltage charges on my guns. I'm going to be trying to do damage every point I can. You know what I mean? So, like, it's a little bit different. There's, like, different styles that you guys can be playing as. And right now, I'm just pretty much going with the no damage bonus style. So I'm going to be hitting mostly just low damages and then, like, utter crushing people. So we'll see how things go with this match. We have Sigil on their team, Lyros, Lynx, Lucifer on our team. I don't know. This is going to be an interesting game, I guess you can say. And then we got Toilet Plunger, who's been talking sick, acting like he's the shit after he beat me when I wasn't even in a state to play Lockdown. Like, that was the funniest part, I think. I remember this guy even made, like, he made a forum post acting like he's sick and shit. He's like, oh, I beat Mini. Like, bro, yeah, I understand you beat me, but one, I was... Oh, I'm not even gonna bother to say it, bro. Let me just let you guys know, I wasn't sober when I was playing that game, straight. And this guy felt nice about it. It's like, okay, so just watch in the tournament, bro. If I'm against you, just watch, bro. That's the funny thing. I'll let him have his little high horse time. It's better that way. It's honestly better that way. Like, don't kill me. Let's go dodge. Oh, you're just up there chilling. Okay. I'll need someone to try and cap this point and actually get some random wrecking. I'm trying to wreck people individually, bruv. See what we got. Neo, you're running Arcana. Lyros. As you guys can see, that's how you actually kite and go around. Now, that was me using a Mercurial demo suit. You know, Jelly and Helm, so I have no damage bonuses. But as you can see, like, once you get on a certain level, you're able to pull things off like that. And I really enjoy, you know, the feel of having the MSI still. It's not like I'm lacking the MSI where I'm going, like, before Fencing Jacket Vogue. Like, nah, I still have some speed on me. You know, even though I'm only running with no Vogue here. Yeah, see that? What happened there is that even though I'm attacking, they still manage to get the cancel frames, which is can be annoying. But most of the times, I'm able to run up to them and just simply, like, attack them as they go. So, you know, it was kind of obvious that the AT was on there as well, considering that you're doing, a straight-on, like, turn around while you're using mouse movement. But I'm not even going to bother with that. Like, at the end of the day, they can use AT and they can do whatever they want. Like, it doesn't change the fact that you still have an even chance of killing them, as long as you're not spamming Atron and shit, you know? Like, it doesn't really leave you that big of a disadvantage, but, like, the AT blasters can be annoying, but they're not, like, the end of the world. I was trying to switch to, like... See that? Yeah, exactly, right there. So, I did the Fearless Rigadoon hit, it goes through, and then Sigil, with the same Final Flourish, with the same range, manages to hit me. That's the kind of thing I'm talking about. So, like, there are certain moments there in the matches where you can obviously tell that, like, you know, sometimes the ping is not 100% accurate, and you also gotta factor that. So it's like, sometimes you gotta add excess cover fire. Even though there's nobody there, it's like you just gotta fire your gun for no reason in case they happen to come into your range. You know? Like that. Like, see, like, that never showed that it hit them directly, but, like, they moved into it, you know? And right there, no one Vincies? No one Vincies? No invinciframes and bang. No invinciframes and bang. Still gets taken. I don't care about Lynx, to be honest. Like, I saw Lynx there. At the end of the day, I know Lynx was going to kill me. You can feel happy about your little Gilded Griffin kill. Like, I really don't care. All I really cared about was getting the kill on the two who were up top, because that's where the actual action was, you know? Like, recons aren't fun. Like, recons are just the guys that just come out of nowhere and try and get little pickoff kills, you know? The only way that you're actually going to take me as a recon is if you deathmark me, and then we have an exchange of blows, you know? Otherwise, you gotta come out of nowhere. That's called a single switch. I'm sure you guys have seen people do it before. And then again with the... Oh no, that time that was Sigil. I was assuming it was a recon that time, to be honest. I never saw a final flourish come out there, but hey. I mean... It was, I'm pretty sure it is running ASI on it. I don't know what kind of ASI, but we can always check inspectors on that is. Could be low. No, it is high. Yeah, I was expecting high or very high, to be honest, because the way that it came out there, I'm only running ASI high on my regular ones, ASI low, and then it's like, you know, ASI med from Strike Booster. So it's really nothing impressive, to be honest. I'm just running a handicap set right now. That's the whole point of this. Show you what I can do with a handicap set, and it's quite nice because I managed to take out Lyros relatively easily. All about timing. Don't forget, I can always have the advantage on you. That's what I like about it, because I'm able to stay mobile. I'm able to stay mobile with the Mercurial. So I always have the advantage when it comes to the gun. Even though they have more range, I can always dodge their attacks. I have the ability to go in, shoot a gun, and still dodge them. Even though they have an Argent Peacemaker, which is really quick, I can still have the speed advantage, just because of my MSI. Just because of my MSI. It gives me the speed advantage, but they have the power advantage in a way. In a way, like, even then Dragon Scales didn't even give you any boosts. So like, it's still pretty even when it's me versus Lynx. Go heal. Go heal. Wow, Lyros is forever healing. It's alright. Yeah, guys, seven caps, 8-point-something K. Interesting indeed. I don't even know how many matches I played, but I'm sure I played quite a number of matches, so. That was the Random Wrecking Jelly Mercurial Edition. I had a decent amount of fun, to be honest. Like, you know, there were certain moments where I got really pissed off because I was getting robbed in terms of ping and, like, you know, frame skips. But at the end of the day, like, I just gotta calm down and realize that it's Spiral Knights and there's gonna be a whole lot of that. I just gotta live with it. I just gotta suck it up and live with it. Like, I know there's a whole lot of moments where I can be killing people and I just get lagged out. It just pisses me off. Like, it really does, but it's like, come on. It's a game which is not really optimized for use on computer, in my opinion, because it's on Java, bro. You guys aren't even running an actual engine. It's like that alone. You can't really expect much in terms of performance and, like, fluent performance. And I'm running a gaming PC, by the way, so when I'm running lag with a gaming PC, I honestly feel it for you guys who are running some, like, your 2GB laptops and shit. Like, I understand, because, like, I was there at one point, and I was recording with Fraps on those same laptops that you guys are running, by the way. So, like, trust me, I know what you guys have to deal with, but please don't assume that just because I have a 780 Ti and shit like that, that I have absolutely no lag. Like, no, it's not like that. Just because I can play FSC 60fps on high doesn't mean I don't get lag. Like, no, the servers still affect me. The game optimization and the actual offline shit too affects me in terms of like stuff that are localized, like, you know, when it comes to actual attacks and things like that. I get actual lags with that, so it happens to everyone, and it's just something that we gotta cope with. But besides that, like, I had a lot of fun using this set. Even with no damage bonuses, I realized that you're still able to take out your opponents within like 7 hits with a Rigadoon. Yeah, it takes that many, to be honest. It really does, but I mean, it's still possible, and I've managed to like get a few wrecks on some people within the last few matches, but most of the time it was just me getting dominated by Grand Foss, you know. But I mean, at the end of the day, like, if they ever select me to use a Grand Foss to random wrecking, then just know that I'm not gonna hold back, because I've been waiting for so long to use that. Like, I've been waiting so long to use that. Yeah, like, trust me, if I ever get that in random wrecking, just know I am not holding back whatsoever. Like, just know, if I get this, I'm not holding back. One or the other. Those are the only two chimes I'm ever gonna try in random wrecking. Like, just understand, if I get a heavy sword, which is a sealed sword upgrade, I'm going try hard. I am going damage hog. I am going all out, bro. And if I get a toothpick, oh yeah, and I will get a toothpick, it's like, oh my god, bro. I'm not even gonna say anything. Like, I just can't wait until they select me to get a Divine Avenger or Grand Foss and Random Wrecking. Like, oh my god, the levels of disrespect I'll be giving back to people is gonna be disrespectful, bro. Yeah, but anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. You know, it was a fair bit of fun, you know, using the Rigadoon in lockdown with no damage bonuses. Like, holy shit, bro. Like, it takes so many hits to kill people. So, like, I just imagine now, like, imagine me going full cat with damage max on everything. Like, dude, instead of me killing people in 7 hits, I'll be killing them in, like, 4 hits, 5 hits with a Rigadoon. If it's with a BTB, it'll be 4 hits. So, like, you know, it'll be really, really nice, because I'll be able to multitask a lot better. I won't have to focus on hitting them 7 times before they're unable to hit me. You know, like I can hit them 4 times and then they'll be dead. It'll be so much nicer. Because then I can focus on another person. Because at the end of the day, like, this is split defenses with a 2-star helm, by the way. So you guys also gotta factor that. Like, I'm not using, like, 5-star everything. Like, no, I'm splitting defenses with a 2-star helm. Like, you know, I'm not meant to take hits. And I'm not meant to do damage. Like, this is actually a handicapped set. So, again, peace out, YouTubers. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And I shall see you guys in the next random wrecking video. Peace out, YouTubers.